It's the news many parents have been hanging out for.
Breaking news from Pfizer.
Medical trial shows its coronavirus vaccine is safe.
For children as young as 5.
The trial on more than 2,000 5 to 11-year-olds finding Pfizer is safe and extremely effective. The company claiming just 10 micrograms, a third of an adult dose, prompts an immune response similar to that in older teens and young adults. Pfizer's set to apply for emergency use approval through the US Food and Drug Administration in coming weeks, with our government also getting prepared.
If an application is received for this age group, obviously then the TGA will very quickly go to assess this information and make a decision. We've got ample supply for all of us, for now and in the future.
12 to 15-year-olds are already eligible for the jab in many countries, though some are proceeding with caution.
The UK has opted for one shot. That's because of that really very tight debate that's going on about the overall benefit of the vaccines.
Back home, almost a quarter of New South Wales' 12 to 15-year-olds are already first dosed, providing some extra protection. Now they're allowed a friend's bubble at home.
The mental health issues and the other socialisation issues, the fact that we're human beings, means that it has to be a balance.
With lockdown states just weeks from opening up and schools set to start heading back, is there any urgency to vaccinate our littlest Aussies?
It doesn't tend to cause severe COVID very commonly, but because Delta is more infectious, there are still going to be more children getting in hospital and getting severe disease. There is an overall benefit in vaccinating children.
Well, epidemiologist Professor Tony Blakely has just released new modelling on what COVID brings us next, and he joins us now. Professor, is there any urgency to vaccinate 5 to 11-year-olds here in Australia?
Well, I don't want to say it's not a race because, you know, how badly that went last time. But it would be good to do it as quickly as practicable because the children will benefit from that because they get a small benefit for their own health. Also means their schools, their community clubs, their sporting facilities are more likely to stay open so they can have a better life. And it's better for all the rest of us in the community because it adds to that resilience, to that ability to dampen the transmission. So this is really exciting. I thought your package at the beginning was great. It's actually really exciting to see this news coming through.
Parents in the lockdown states are pretty anxious about school going back next month, me included. What do you see happening in that first month or so without vaccination?
Yeah, it's going to be a bit touch and go. So basically, we will basically release the schools back in and we'll be watching the numbers like crazy because neither New South Wales or Victoria wants to crash through 2,000 or 3,000 cases a day because that'll put the health system under stretch. We know that sending the kids back to school is going to amp up the transmission, but we know at the same time that the vaccine coverage is chasing it down. And it's going to be a balancing between those two things. We're going to watch it really closely. But, you know, it's great news that we can start vaccinating 5+ some, you know, maybe in a couple of months.
So, Tony, you released new modelling today, and I think it's fair to say I like your new stuff better than your old stuff because this is called 2022 Will Be Better. Give us the good news. How's it going to be better?
Well, A, it's not hard to be better than this year and last year, right? No, but let's cut to the chase here. 80% vaccination, if you include the kids, so let's go with that because the news today, and if you have a minimum level of basal, you know, standards whereby people like me work at home most of the time, there's density limits, that sort of thing, but we're not in lockdown, we can actually have quite a reasonably well-controlled health impact. That's great. But we'd still be in lockdown 1-4, 14% of time on our modelling with a wide range of uncertainty. So we still need to do better. The good news, on the good news front, is that we have innovations coming our way that will help us do that. Ventilation and air filtration in buildings will help. Getting some phone apps that actually work for contact tracing makes a big difference when we put it in our models and see what happens. Things like masking better. I know it's boring, old, same old, but keeping that masking going will help. So we're now starting to develop the toolkit that will allow us to live with the virus somewhat next year.
So I'm just thinking, with those things, you said 14% of the time we would be in lockdown without those things.
Yeah, we want to go less than that.
Yeah, I get that. Can you get to zero? Like, is there a way you can model that we don't have lockdowns at all?
Yeah, so as far as the best estimate, so these models have wide uncertainty, but the one that takes you there on the average, all of 90% vaccination, increased mask wearing, what we thought might be the effect of mass rapid antigen testing. All those things tip you that way, which is really encouraging. It means that we might have enough tools in our toolkit to be able to make decisions about which way to live our life next year. The kicker in there, I'm sorry about the bad news, Waleed. Yeah. The kicker
this is
in
like
there
your first album.
The kicker in there is we know from Israel and other countries these vaccines are waning. So we'll have to boost at some point next year and hope to get better vaccines that we can take once and last for 5 years. But we're still going to be doing that booster game next year.
All right. Professor Tony Blakely, we will have to leave it there. Thanks so much for your time this evening.
Pleasure. I hope it's useful.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.